السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، أشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله الأمين ورحمته للعالمين، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، my dear respected brothers, sisters, our children, and actually I can safely say also my grandchildren, because I'm at now in my 70th year, so there must be generations of children that we have. Again, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Now, let me begin where I began. I began by praising Allah. نحن, we are in the habit of praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala under all circumstances. We say alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bear witness that He assured us that He will be the guardian of people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says are people of piety, waliyu salihin. That we send our peace and blessings upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who has been sent as a mercy for actually what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-alameen. These are the beginning words that I have said so that inshallah I can speak to you tonight. And hope and pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make my words go through straight to your minds and hearts so that we can see what kind of response you have for us. When I see videos like this, and there have been so many of them, I always remember what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam predicted is going to happen. And everything that we see around us is actually predicted by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the good thing about it is that, alhamdulillah, Irfan, all the people are gang, they took care of what the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam said. When you see these things, you take advantage of it and you initiate things. This word, badiru bil a'mal. Badir means take initiative, don't wait. What the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam want us not to wait for? He said, "Badiru bil a'mali sittan." Six things are going to happen, and they are happening around us, and I'm going to list them to you. He said, when you see these things happening, you take initiative. Don't wait for anyone. And alhamdulillah, an initiative has been taken. And I just want to say to Brother Umar and the brothers in Afaq, Jazakumullahu khayran, because when we are invited to be party to what they are doing, we feel happy because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them that privilege of actually calling us to task. What did the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam say about when that you need to talk initiative? Nobody is going to help you. He said, "Badiru bil amali sittan, amarat al-sufaha, bay' al-hukm, استخفافا بالدم، كثرة الشرط، قطيعة الرحم، ونشوا يتخذون القرآن مزامير، يقدمون أحدهم ليغنيهم وإن كان أقلهم فقه." Just look around you for Muslims and see what is happening. All these things should not have happened. If we had the proper rulers, people have, alhamdulillah, we have a lot of wealth in our countries, there is a lot of resources, people have, but they are completely fell in the hands of people who mismanage them. That is why needy people, we have all these things because of that. The Prophet also says, "Bay' al-hukm," like there is no fairness, there is no justice, all the things that we talk about and we hear, and all these things that we have, they are not there. He said, again, there will be a lot of bloodshed. Just go turn any news channel today. 70 people are killed here, 80 people are killed here, these people have done this, not like that, and this is what happens to us. He said, even people will sever their wombs, قطيعة الرحم. And actually, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this in the Quran, وَتُقَطِّعُ أَرْحَامَكُمْ. Very close people, cousins and cross cousins and so on. Then, on top of this, he said, means of oppression. Oppression does not necessarily mean that you oppress people. When you read in these flyers, what they do is young people. They trap them, they get them, they use their organs, and then let them die. And this is happening. And also, Allah, the Prophet ﷺ went to say, these are how people are being oppressed. They are deprived of their resources. They are deprived of everything that they had. And then the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says, people basically will sing the Quran. They sing it, they don't live it. And I'm going to make you tonight, inshallah, at least realize how much singing we do without knowing what is the essence of the message that we are for. And that's where I want to put all of us to task, inshallah. Now, what does that mean? See, when you see these things, one, the human value, like people, humans, every human being, everyone, comes to this world exactly like the other person. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. We all came out of the wombs of our mothers, we knew nothing. جَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then develop our hearing, develop our sight, and then develop our intellect. Any child can make the difference. Any child can make the difference. And there is an experiment that has been done. I don't know whether you followed it or not. They brought children from the deserts of Africa to Harvard University. And they are top their classes over there. If you didn't see it, go and Google this in the Google and you will see it. That there's absolutely no difference. If you give a child from any corner of the world the same opportunity you give it to another child, they can even be achieving more than that. And this is why when I was told about AFAQ, and especially helping students and children, any child can have a potential. And these are the people who are going to make the difference. We lived it, we saw it. We brought up children right in this country, right here in Canada. We brought them, we told the parents, listen, trust in yourself, build confidence in yourself, go with these children, and I can tell you now, alhamdulillah, we see them. A child, just like any other child. You bring them up, you really put them in their mind that they can do it, and so on. And that's what we are here for, is to bring these back children to help them help. And you can actually help in any way you want. Even understanding of our faith. Many people think a Muslim is the one who prays good and fasts good and so on. None of these acts of worship, not the salah, not the siyam, not even the hajj, is an end to itself. I can tell you what Allah says about them. Look at how Allah treats us when we pray. The Prophet, let me say this first and then take you back to where is it. Once the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was asked, they said to him, Ya Rasulullah, who is the best among people? He didn't say the one who prays most, he fasts most, establish nightly prayers. He said, Khayrun nasi anfa'ahum linnas. The one who is the best is the one who is good to other people. Then they said to him, what are the best of deeds? And look at the list he gave. He said first, surur tudkhilu ala qalbi muslim. Surur, just to make somebody happy. Wallahi, when you see these kids, and you see, you might not know them, you might not who they are, but if they receive anything from you, the joy that you put in their hearts in itself is a reward for you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قالت surur tudkhilu ala muslim, aw tatrul anhu ju'. A person who's angry and you can see it hungry, you see what they are, you repeat this anger from them. Or takshif anhu qurba, or to take him or relieve him from distress, from hardship, from difficulty. This is the deen that we believe in. That's what we live for. He went on to say, actually he said, wala an amshi fi hajata akhi, that is better for me to go and address a need of a person is better than living and sitting in the masjid of the Prophet for a whole month. And you know what the Prophet said about the prayer in al-Masjid al-Nabawi? He said the salah, one salah in the masjid is how many? 100 salah from any other place. He said even this, and by the way, if I roll back the incident, let me give you the story, because sometimes when you put something in the scripture, you understand it. Among the people who were very close to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, was his cousin, Ibn Abbas. Since he was young, and actually when the Prophet died, they said he was only 12. But the Prophet called him Hibrul Ummah, like the scorer of this Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, close to the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everybody was shattered. They lost the Prophet. They don't know what to do. Some people didn't even believe that the Prophet died. He said, بينما أنا, he was sitting in the masjid, and people were completely taken by the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, is دخل علي رجل. A man came and then sat beside me. because he was actually staying in the masjid. It was called i'tikaf, and we're approaching Ramadan. We hope Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gets us 2 months of Ramadan. He said he thought, the man, that I'm busy with i'tikaf, with prayers. And he didn't want to say, he just said salam to me and he sat down. Then he said, أَقُلْتُ لَهُ أَلَكَ حَاجَةً? Do you need anything? He said, the man didn't answer me. But I felt tears were running on his eyes. And I felt he needs something. And I felt he was, thought I am in i'tikaf, quote unquote. He didn't want to disturb me. He said, I took his hand, took him out to where the grave of the Prophet was, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said to him, Wallahi, inni sami'tu sahib hadha al-qabr. I heard this by my own ears. Saying that, if you go to solve a problem or help a person in need, it's better for you than not to stand this night I'm here, but a whole month in my masjid. That's how he understood it. And this is why sometimes we don't really do it. Let me go back where I said to you, none of the acts of worship is an end of itself. If you read in the Quran, I'm going to take you on it one by one. What is the essence of the prayer? The prayer is not an end of itself. It is actually like a charge. You know, this cell phone needs a charge. Then you have a small thing needs a bigger charge. Then a bigger charge. Then a bigger charge. Take it this way. Read with me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمُ الصَّلَاةِ. When you finish your prayer, you do it perfectly well. The prayer is not an end in itself. Why? Because Allah said, فَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِكُمْ. يعني, I pray, I come out of the prayer, Allah says, remember when Allah, you're walking, you're sitting, which means you're dealing. That's how you pray. Now we are approaching the month of Ramadan. Look at how Allah puts it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. The whole essence of the month of Ramadan is not the hunger, is not the thirsty. It is that you charge yourself, that you came out to be grateful to Allah. You feel hungry temporarily. Remember the hunger of people who don't. That's how you feel about people. It develops your willpower. You go for this, you go for that. So Allah says, this is where you fulfill what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to go for you. Hajj, the peak of our ibadah. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about it? The same words. فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُم مَنَاسِكَكُمْ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا. Why? He said, when Hajj, we do all these rituals and you go through all the things that you go for it, you come out of Hajj to begin a good relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I say, when you fulfill it, then remember Allah more than what you remember of your own parents. Why? Because Hajj should really give you that thing so that you feel for people, you put your hearts for them, and so on. This is why, when we come and see all of this happening in our eyes, and we are called upon to help, and we wanted to do this, remember the following. One, any one of us can be in that position. You don't know when, you don't know where, you don't know how, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Jazakallahu khairan, shukran lak ya akhi, barakallahu khairan. And this is why the verses that were recited to you in the very beginning, that you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. And by the way, we are approaching Ramadan. I said this today. I want you to approach Ramadan with these understandings. That anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in our position, anything, is a trust from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hands. No one is going to take it with him to his grave. Look at all the people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, even people that we know. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, measure up to what Allah expects of you. What does Allah expect of us? Actually, Allah said we will not actually get to that point where we can all be to what Allah has. Everyone has a shortcoming. The word measure Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or what Allah measures, we measure up to what Allah expects of us, is that none of us here, and I'm going to test you tonight, that we'll measure up to what Allah truly expects of us. Let me take it this way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, عَلِمَ اللَّهُ أَلَّنْ تُحْصُوا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after he narrated things, then he says, عَلِمَ اللَّهُ أَلَّنْ تُحْصُوا. Why? You're not. And then made it easier for us. He said, فَقْرَأُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةِ. Then he added, وَأَقْرِضُوا اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا. وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله. Not as is. He said هو خيرا وأعظم أجرا. And then he concluded by saying and feel grateful to Allah and واستغفر الله. Ask Allah forgiveness. Why? Each one of us sees these things happening in front of him. We are called just to help in as much as we can. And anything makes a big difference to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why all what Allah mentioned in the Quran about giving and so on is more than anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about it. We are, like me and you, be answerable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before we might not know, we might not have seen, we might not have understood what is going on, but now we see it in front of our eyes. We don't have an excuse. You will be answerable to Allah, and I'll be answerable too with you, that Allah will ask you, what did you do about it? This is why I began by saying what the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, بادروا بالأعمال. Each one of us sitting here now, you know yourself better than anyone can tell you. Everyone knows himself better than anyone can think of you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah tests you by what he has given you. He says this, and the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام explained it very well. He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اِخْتَصَّ أَقْوَامًا بِالنِّعَمْ. Allah has given certain people a lot of bounties. لِمَنَافِعِ الْعِبَادِ, so that they can use it to help others who are in need. He said, if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you for it, keep you for it, and enjoy it with Allah and increase it for it, look at what he says. He said, أَقَرَّهُمْ عَلَيْهَا مَا زَالُوا فِي حَوَائِجِ النَّاسِ. So long as they respond to the needs of others, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assure that, give you the surety that you are going to enjoy what Allah gave you, increase what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you, and so on. What if you don't? That's the warning. He said, فَإِذَا مَلُّوهُمْ, if they are bored with them, they cannot, Allah can switch it or switch you or take you from what you have. That's actually what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deals with us. This is reflected in the Quran itself. And let me put it this way to you. Read with me. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, ha antum ha'ula. Literally, when you say ha antum ha'ula is like here you are. Where are we? He said ha antum ha'ula'i tud'auna. You are being invited. Technically, Allah said this to us so that you understand where you are. He said, "Ha antum haulai tud'auna litunfiqu fi sabilillah," so that you can give something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah pauses us to remind me and you. He said, "Faminkum may yabkhal." Some of you will hold. No matter how much cases they put, no matter how many videotapes you see, how many people they bleed for you, how many speakers they talk to you, he said, some people will hold. منكم من يبخل. But Allah warns. He said, ومن يبخل فإنما يبخل عن نفسه. You hold against yourself. Why? He said, والله الغني وأنتم الفقراء. Every one of us needs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actually, every human being, not only me and you. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء إلى الله والله هو الغني الحميد. إن يشاء يثبكم ويأتي بخلق جديد. وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزِ. We have lived through this. I have been here for 40 years, 40, since I came to this country. I have been to so many functions. We have seen so many people. We go to them and tell them exactly what we are telling you today, and some hold, and they regretted it. They don't come out of it good. Because Allah says this, إِن تَتَوَلَّوْا يَسْتَبْدِلْ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَكُونُوا أَمْثَالَكُمْ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you don't stand up, measure up to what Allah has asked you for, then Allah might replace you by others. And it doesn't take Allah anything to replace any one of us. Anytime, without even a writ, without a warning, without anything. That's how death comes to us. And this is why we want you to think about this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put you in a position to help others who are in need. Allah did not yet put you in a position where you beg of the help of other people. This is why one of our imams, Imam Shafi'i, rahmatullah alayhi, used to write poetry in many of the things that he gave in wisdom. He said, "An-nasu bin-nas." An-nas bin-nas. Like you give for people, people stand for people. So long as he says ما دام الحياء بهم. So long as they feel shy. الناس بالناس ما دام الحياء بهم. والسعد لا شك. He said تارات وهبات. Times of good they will come and go, come and go and so on. He said وأفضل الخلق ما بين الورى. He said a person تقضى على يده للناس حاجاته. If you want to rank high, he says that you see how much at your hand, with your hand, with your help, other people's needs are addressed. And then he advises us. He says, لا تمنعن يد المعروف عن أحد. When you are called upon and you can help, don't hold. Don't hold. He says, وأفضل الخلق. The best among people is the person that, as Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم actually said, that when people come to you, you become the source of their help. Then he said something that actually alert us. He said, قد مات قوم وما ماتت مكارمهم. That there are a lot of people who are past gone. Still the effect of their generosity continues and persists. وقد عاش قوم وهم في الناس أمواته. And that you might see a person among you, but they're just like dead people. Nobody remembers them. So what I want you, inshallah, to go with me tonight. These brothers came, and I'm telling you, wallah, I'm very proud of the brothers who take these initiatives. Because it takes a lot of courage, a lot of time, a lot of determination, a lot of confidence, actually, that you are going to pull people to do it. What we are going to get from you, inshallah, tonight, and alhamdulillah, I came to know also from him today, that they already got their charitable status. In this country, when you have a charitable status, you get a tax break, you get this, you get that, and then you sustain it, inshallah, for us. So, what I'm going to start with you is the following. As I said in the very beginning, if we can really get Muslim children, these children that are being lost, that are being deprived of this, and they have that capacity, mashallah, to make the difference, they will be the people who are going to lead this ummah for us, inshallah. I lived in this country, as I said too many times, now for 40 years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me the opportunity to be a school principal. Actually, this is a very famous school where I started in Canada. And I have a generation of children graduating from these children. They are now the best supporters of all the activities that we have. And you'll be surprised. I can put you through a challenge, all of you. Every one of you here. I want you to challenge one of my students, just one. And I tell you who this person is, how he did it. When we go to functions normally, we look at people and we hope for somebody whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed with wealth and that he can make a difference. At times, although I don't know too many of you, I met some of you, mashallah, I come here many times, but sometimes you look at somebody whom Allah blessed with wealth, you say, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open his heart, and that makes a difference for us. So in that function, I asked the people, I said, whom do you have here that you really think has a heart of a person who is kind, who is soft, who can really make a difference for people? So they told me about a brother. And then I said to them, listen, how much did this person, يعني, they said, well, the brother has this business, مش عارف إيه, in medical technologies, he does this, he does that. So I asked them, how much he gave you last time? They said, wallahi, this man started with $25,000 for us, and he's there. Weeks. So I said, okay, would you mind me try maybe $50,000 for him? So I kept saying, and I'm going to ask you this, is there any person here whom Allah gave him wealth, who is in that category? The Prophet ﷺ said, "Inna Allah akhtassa aqwaman bin ni'am." Is mahal al-ni'am. And secondly, he has a heart. A person can be kind enough to save children, to save these things that we have. They said, well, fine, go ahead. Wallahi, this is what I did. So I started, I said, I will try the man, I'll start with $50,000. For some people, $50,000 doesn't mean much. And that man, they told me, he has a lot of wealth. So I started with $50,000. Everybody was numb. Because, by the way, asking people and you're going to be tested tonight is not easy. You know what Allah said, this verse is the boys. The minute we come to ask you to give money, rest assured, the shaitan will come on you. Because shaitan hates people who give. Hates him. And Allah said this in the Quran exactly like this. الشيطان with the definite article. يعدكم الفقر. What does the shaitan does? No matter how much you have, no matter how pain you see, and so on, he will tell you all kinds of things so that he can actually tempt you not to give. Not only this, once you hold, he will command you to
to do evil with what you have done good for it. And look at the words. الشيطان يعيدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء. The opposite is what Allah says. He said, والله الله سبحانه وتعالى يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضل. والله واسع عليم. Look at the contra. That when you give, Allah promises you the following. First, giving is the shortcut for cleansing your sins. Cleanse your sins. If you came here as a sinner, you did something, you are preparing for Ramadan, you want to wipe it all, give charity. Allah said that. Not only this, Allah will compensate you for what you give, multiples of it, and reverses that were read for you. So when I said this, the brother didn't respond. You know who responded? One of my students, wallah, he put his hand up. In the beginning, I thought he's joking. So I asked him, are you serious? He said, yes, I'm serious. And wallahi, I'm telling you, this boy came to me in the school in grade 3. طيب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much blessed him because he gives and gives and gives. A second after that, the man that we are looking for put his hand up and added another $50,000. Now, that's not what the challenge I want you to be in. In the following fundraising, the very boy that came to me, he said, Ammu, Ammu means uncle. Wallahi, every time I get, I don't know how much money comes in my hand. I said, now, what are you up to? Wallahi, he said, I will donate $100,000. One student. So I said, MashaAllah, we live to see this. We live to see it. Now my challenge to you is, one, and wallahi, he gave it. Allah is my witness. طيب. And I want to put all of you tonight, all of you, if we can put $100,000 together. We can pull it. And I want you to match this one young boy. He's still with us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him. We keep praying for him and that. Why does he do that? He said, Sri Ammu, every time I give, I remember what Allah says to me. He says first, what? أَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا جَعَلَكُمْ مُسْتَخْلَفِينَ فِيهِ. Allah said, give from what Allah gave you authority. Because when we live in Saudi, He said, Ammu, I remember what you tell us all the time. Allah says the following. Anything you give, the boy just read it for you. He said, مَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ. Whatever you give, whether it's small, it's big, صغيرة, ولا كبيرة, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala compensate you for it. And the more you give, the more you get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to multiples that we have. Imagine right now you are sitting listening to me and say to yourself, طيب, let me just challenge myself. How much can I do? We need about $100,000 tonight. طيب? I'm going to ask you this question now. Is there any one of us here? Anyone? Whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed with wealth. He or she, and I always say he or she, because Allah says this, al-mu'minun, believing men, wal-mu'minat, believing women. And it gave us examples of people who did that. People used to give, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them. They start from a zero. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of this intention they have. And in our history, there are so many people that I can mention for you. So if you feel Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed you as well, that you want to give it to Allah. By the way, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, when you give to Allah, ask Allah against what you give as much as you want. قَالَ فَأَكْثِرُوا فَإِنَّمَا تَسْأَلُونَ اللَّهِ. Say, Ya Allah, I'm going to give this. Protect my wealth. Protect my health. Protect my family. Protect my children. Protect my parents. Anything you can. He said, أكثروا. يعني as if he's giving you an open way to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as you do. That's number one. Number two, remember anything you give now falls in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even before it reaches these people. How? Read with me the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ألم يعلموا, don't you know, ألم يعلموا أن الله هو Allah himself يقبل التوبة عن عباده ويأخذ الصدقات. Don't you? Allah says that you don't you know that Allah himself actually accept us when we repent, and it is he who takes what we give to him. Keep in mind too that Allah will multiply what you give, protect what you have, and all of this are coming into what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. This is why I want to go with you tonight, inshallah, step by step. We just pause for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. If you are that person, I want you to ask yourself, tonight you want to say to yourself, Allah bless me with wealth. I can afford to do this. I can help these people with it. And I wanted to come up with what I'm going to start with. I need somebody who will say, I will start with $10,000 tonight, inshallah. If you feel that person, before you do it, let me pause you on this. Just one of the verses that was read to us, it might have passed unnoticed. The problem that I see many times when the Quran is being read, when the hadith of the Prophet are being mentioned, many times you don't pay attention to what is being read. But let me slow motion it so that you read with me. One of the verses that our young boy, whose name Abdul Wahab read, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this, الَّذِينَ يُنفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ بِالْلَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ الَّذِينَ, those, يُنفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ, they spend from their wealth during the day and the night. سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَ. سِرًّا means secretly, عَلَانِيَ means publicly. Now these words, سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَ, repeated itself in the Quran 4 times. The verse that was read to you is from Surah Al-Baqarah, for those of you who follow the Quran. The second is in a chapter told, called Ar-Ra'd, the thunder bolt, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ صَبُرُوا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِمْ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ, again, سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَ. That's number two. Number three, Allah says it directly, but this time he asked the Prophet, عليه الصلاة والسلام, his messenger, to tell us what Allah told us already. By the way, this reminds us, most of the brothers from the Sudan or from Eritrea, they know that in our countries, our mothers, we used to worry about it. I used to worry about it until I start reading this. You know, when we are little kids, if you want your mother to do something for you, don't ask her in the name of Allah. Ask her in the name of the Prophet. Yani, if you come to your mom and say, Yumma alayk, alayk Allah, or something like that, I ask you in the name of Allah, she might be reluctant. But if you say, Yumma alayk al-Rasul, right, she will respond. We used to worry about it. Do Allah give more regard to the Allah or the Prophet? And then I came to this verse. I said to myself, why does Allah say this to us, sirran wa alaniya, twice? But then he comes to tell the Prophet, as if we might respond better to the Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam. Wallahi. This is why he says in Surah Ibrahim, قُلْ لِعِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. He's commanding the Prophet to tell us what he already told us. He said, قُلْ لِعِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَيُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَ. 3, 4. There is a chapter called Fatir. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Fatir says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ, again, سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَ. Why does Allah repeat this for us? Because some of us feel reluctant sometimes. They don't want to share their charity. Actually, our scholars say the opposite. They say if you are raising funds for a public cause, it is better to declare your charity. And I go with the example of this young boy. When he put his hand up, that rich man put his hand a second, a fratric son after him. طيب. Now, by the way, there is a bonus to this. Because just now also, he read from Surah Al-Baqarah, a different one. He said, إِن تُبْدُوا الصَّدَقَاتِ, if you declare your charity, فَنِعِمَّا هِي. It's beautiful. If you give it to the poor, وَإِن تُخْفُوهَا وَتُؤْتُوهَا الْفُقَرَاءِ. This is why the scholars said, if you are making a public donation for a public cause, declare it, because somebody else might wake up and just actually follow what you do. If you are giving it to a poor person, you don't embarrass the people. By the way, again, I hope you didn't pass unnoticed, wallahi, this is witnessed even in the Sudan. Of all the people that we have in that country, right? You go to the masajid, one of the brothers, and this is common. You find people from Western Sudan, this part of the country, they stand up, they ask people. The only people who never do this are the people from Eritrea. They have this, what Allah said, يحسبهم الجاهل أغنياء من التعفف لا يسألون الناس إلحافا. يعني when you see them from their generosity, their kindness, they are so bashful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they don't ask. And Allah described these people in the Quran. A jahil means an ignorant person will think these people are very rich. The riches in their hearts and in their minds, and these people have it. And these are the people that we want you, inshallah, to extend the hand and to help them, inshallah. Did I make it clear? If you feel after all of this, you want to give us $10,000 to open this function, inshallah. This is the fairest fundraising. And that will give an encouragement to these brothers. And will make us really feel in this Muslim Ummah of Muhammad, there are people who make a difference. If you are that person, let me see your hand. Let me see your hand. If Allah gave you a good business, Allah gave you a good profession, you don't have to hesitate for it. And look at what Allah says. The minute you give it, he said, مَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ, immediately Allah says, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ. Right? إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُخْلِفُ. These are the words he says. He will know it, he will compensate, and Allah will take it from you. How? طبعاً نحن, we don't know. Allah says, he will take it, and we don't know how Allah looks. This depends on what we say in our words. Like we say, what befits the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you are that person, you want to come up with this one, I want to see your hand. Anyone wants to respond? طيب. I want you to take a pause. Say, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. Think of the words. Think of the words. You are dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You'll be answerable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah gave you it, tell us it, inshallah. If you feel you want to be that person, and mind you, this organization work on long term. يعني if you want to make a pledge, as they said, you see these forms here, pledge the $10,000 for them. You can pay it $1,000 a month, pay it $500 a month. Just make that commitment. Let them initiate the work, and then you can carry it from there, inshallah. Anyone wants to respond? Anyone? أي واحد؟ أي حد؟ أخذ أخ الله سبحانه وتعالى يفتح قلوب الناس. If you feel that person, you want to be that person, inshallah, I want to see your hand. Anyone? طيب. Take a pause. قولوا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. We got one? Did we get it? Inshallah. Did you ask? الله أكبر. جزاك الله خيرا أخي. جعلك الله من أهل السبق. You know, I'm telling you, Allah praised people who came forward. السابقون السابقون. أولئك المقربون. The Prophet said there are some people on the day of judgment, Allah will come and pray them in front of angels, not even people, because they take initiative that we have. May Allah reward you, أخي. الله يفتح عليك ويبارك فيك ويجعل كل الخير لك. وادعو الله بما تشاء. إن شاء الله. Anyone wants to match the brother? Because we need to build it. If you feel I want to add it, give it another 10,000. It makes it easier for us. It makes the work easier. It gives people actually the energy they want to do it. Because now we have hope in you. I said to you the hadith of Rasulullah said, Badiru bil a'mal. Forget about anyone. Just ask yourself, what am I going to do? How am I going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Anyone wants to give another 10? If not, I'm going to move faster. Can I get two people to give us $5,000 each? We have to, 5-5, mashallah. See, that's another mubadara. قولوا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. Let me pause you on this. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says something. I really want you to pay attention to it. Allah said, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. Very few people of my servants, Allah says, are truly grateful to me. And how we show gratitude to Allah? By giving from what Allah has given us. نعم. يعني take it this way. قليل من عبادي الشكور. Actually the verse is said by saying Allah described them and he says وقليل ما هم. They are but a few. Who are these few? Allah said I could have prescribed on you. Not only to give charity, give a little bit of this, a little bit. He said I would have prescribed on you. Allah could have made it a must on us that we give all our lives to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only our wealth or everything we have, the homes we own. And mind you, for the sisters, this is Surah An-Nisa. Read with me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَوْ أَنَّا كَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَنْ اِقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ أَوْ اِخْرُجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ مَا فَعَلُوهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ مِّنْهُمْ. If we ask, or had we asked them to give their lives for Allah, give their homes for the sake of Allah, none but few, and few will do it. He said, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ فَعَلُوا مَا يُعَظُونَ بِهِ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. That would have been the best for anyone who will be reminded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. So now we have how many people? Count them. 3. 110, 255. Now are 3. Count yourself in. Anyone wants to add another $5,000? As I said to you, divide it over a period of time. Wallahi, this money will go to children. واحد منهم يدعو, right? One of these. Because they don't know you, you don't know them. Allah knows you and Allah knows them. طيب؟ And you will never regret it. Never. Because you are giving it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake. Not for something, nothing that has to do with you. And people used to give like this. They don't even ask who it is for them, inshallah. أي واحد عايز يضيف another 5,000? Anyone wants to add another 5? Divided. خليها $500 كل شهر. $500 a month. Give it over a period of 10 months. It clears itself by itself. Anyone wants to respond? No, نمشي. طيب. By the way, every time we ask for something, you are not able to do it, the best response to Allah is to ask Allah forgiveness. Wallahi, I tell you why. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wallahu yuqaddiru al-layla wal-nahar. Remember, علم أن لن تحصوا. علم أن لن تحصوا. فتاب عليكم. فقرؤوا ما تيسر من القرآن. علم أن سيكون منكم مرضى. وآخرون يضربون في الأرض يبتغون من فضل الله. وآخرون يقاتلون في سبيل الله. What did he say? He said, فقرؤوا ما تيسر منه. وأقيموا الصلاة. وآتوا الزكاة. وآدي ذا الذي البيت قال وأقرضوا الله قرضا حسنا. وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير. He said, تجدوه عند الله. وخيرا وأعظم أجرا. And then he said, واستغفر الله. نعم نعم. ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. أنا سألت الخمسة, جاءت الخمسة. قول الله أكبر. How many? 4. عدوا. طيب عدوا خمسة. طيب, let me get at least 4 people to give us $2,500. That's $250 بالشهر لعشر شهور. اكتب كده بيل في سبيل الله. Who's going to start? 2,500. I need to build 2 5s. Al agal 2. 2,500, 2,500, 2,500. Shufu ikhwani, asma'u kalami. Al wahid yimsik min Allah. Bidraya. Ha antum haula. Mush Rabbana qal kida. Direct. Tud'awna litunfiqu fi sabilillah. Faminkum man yabkhal. ودي في آخر آية في سورة محمد بالمناسبة صلى الله عليه وسلم. ومن يبخل فإنما يبخل عن نفسه. You don't hold against Afaq or against this kid. You hold against yourself. Why? Allah gives the reason. He said, Wallahu al-ghani wa antum al-fuqara. Allah al-ghani wa antum al-fuqara. Wa in tatawallaw, if you turn and leave, he said, yastabdil qawman ghayrakum, thumma la yakunu amthalakum. هذا ليس قولي, هذا قول الله سبحانه وتعالى. طيب, I need 2 more. 2,500. We are doing well, alhamdulillah. Two people. 2,500, I was going to start. One and two, أهل الخير والفضل, الناس الكرماء, الناس القلوب الرحيم. والله الإنسان يعطي لله. يعني أنت ما عندك, لا تعرف الأولاد دل ولا تشوفهم ولا إيش. One of them can make the difference. أنا أقول هذا للمسلمين all the time. One of these kids that are lost somewhere there might make the difference, could be the only person that this Ummah of Muhammad is waiting for. عند الله ما في شيء بعيد. And you will be a contributor to that, إن شاء الله تعالى. Anyone wants to start? It's 2,500. بدأنا. Another 5. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. They are ahead of us. نعم. طيب. Let me see. I break this. I really need 2 for 2,500. محتاج لاثنين. اثنين كده. يتوكلوا على الله سبحانه وتعالى. قلوب رحيمة. يخلوها كده لله سبحانه وتعالى. 2,500. ونقفل 5,000. ونستمر إن شاء الله. Who's going to be the first? 2,500. Did we get any? أي واحد. 2,500. I always make it easier for people. يا أخي خدت $250 بالشهر. كم تضيع 250 مننا؟ 10. وبعدين by the way, السايكولوجي بتاعت الانفاق انه احيانا انت تنوي تعطي وتتقدم تعطي وربنا يفتح عليك من حيث لا تحتسب. والله هذا الولد انا كلمتكم عنه ياتيني كل مره يقول لي عمو you don't know what I got this deal مش عارف 100,000 this deal. والله يقول لي I learned it the more I give the more Allah gives me. قلت الله يبارك فيك يفتح عليك في الدنيا والآخرة ان شاء الله. ما تخيل يعني ما الانسان ابدا بتتعامل مع الله والله البعيدك بها وعدك. والله يقول وعد الله لا يخلف الله وعده ولكن اكثر الناس لا يعلمون. ليش؟ قال يعلمون ظاهرا من الحياه الدنيا وهم عن الاخره هم غافلون. اولم يتفكروا في انفسهم ما خلق الله السماوات والارض وما الا بالحق واجل مسمى وان كثيرا من الناس بلقاء ربهم لكافرون. أولم يسيروا في الأرض فينظروا شوف إيش الحصل للناس قارون وأصحاب المال وأصحاب الأموال كلها تروح يبقى ما عند الله هو الباقي عند الإنسان إن شاء الله. نعم anyone wants to respond 2500 أي واحد. by the way I don't see sisters أنتوا أيضا في الناس يعني I'm serious. إذا أخت ربنا فاتح عليها بالمال وتستطيع أن تتبرع ما تتوقف. If Allah gave you sisters, وأنا شهدت الله على ذلك. I used to go to the states. طبعاً أكلمتكم. ما في state I didn't go to it. والله شفت نساء تتبرع المرأة بالمئة ألف. مئة ألف. Akron, Ohio, Chicago, what is called Panama, Florida. كلها مرأة تتبرع بمئة ألف. والله I went to Sydney, Australia. قلت الكلام ده للناس هناك. قلت والله في أمريكا إخواتنا أخوات ربنا فاتح عليهم الطبيبات والمهندسات والبيزنس ويمن. تقول لنا تبرعوا تديك مئة ألف. وقلت الكلام ده في سيدني. والله أخت اسمها عائشة تبرعت بمئة ألف. وقالت عمرها ما كان تصدق أنه أحد تبرع بمئة ألف. ما تخلوا على الله. تمسك الله يمسك منكم. تعطوا الله يفتح عليكم. ده الكلام اللي قال الرسول. الرسول يقول ما من يوم. There isn't a single day. But Allah sent two angels. كلكم تعرفوه. قال واحد يقول اللهم أعطي منفقا خلفا. أو الله. الله. These angels. يقول كل ما تعطي ربنا يعطيك. والثاني يقول اللهم أعطي ممسكا تلفا. ما حد عايز يتلف ماله. ما حد عايز يترك أولاده. ما حد عايز كله. كله عند الله سبحانه وتعالى. طيب anyone wants to add another 2500 عشان نمشي. We need to move. We need to move. في واحد واحد طيب واحد استغفر الله قولوا استغفر الله. نعم by the way this is the way والله says ما لكم لا ترجون لله وقارا. Why didn't you show respect and regard for Allah? Somebody asked the prophet said كيف يا رسول الله. قال الاستغفار. When you say استغفر الله actually this is how we give regard to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب let me go to $1,000. How many of you will give $1,000? ألف دولار. Let me see a few hands. ما تقيفوا. $1,000. واحد ما شاء الله. جزاك الله خيرا. Who's going to be number two? 1,000. أخوكم دفع 10,000 قدامكم. وأخوانكم الآخرين خمسة دفعوا ولا أربعة دفعوا 5,000. Ask yourself. $100 بالشهر 10 شهور it is clear. 10 شهور. 10 ما أكثر من كذا. $100 فقط. إن شاء الله. We have one. Who's going to be number two? 2. سبحان الله. 2. $1,000. $1,000. نعم. طيب. Remember what Allah said. Who is holding you now? He said, الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء. شوف المقابل. والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضل. باقي الآيات بالمناسبة عجيبة. قال والله واسع عليم يؤتي الحكمة من يشاء ومن يؤت الحكمة فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب. None but the most intelligent people who can comprehend this. إنك أنت you make one هناك الله أكبر جزاك الله خيرا. You make a deal with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. نعم. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ما شاء الله. طيب OMA, the masjid, they gave $1,000 and they're asking others to contribute. Masajid, organizations, whatever you wanted to have. So you got another $1,000. That's number two. Number three, match them. Start with them, inshallah. Number three, mashallah. I see a beautiful hand there. That's number three. Number four. Number four. خلونا نكملهم خمسة على الأقل. Give me two more. 1,000, 1,000. 1,000, 1,000. Two more. اثنين أيادي مباركة كده. قول والله I want to give $1,000. We need two. Two more. If you choose not to declare it, send the pledge form. عبي الفورم. Fill in the form and send it. That's why, by the way, this الآيات دي عجيبة. يعني لما قلت سراً وعلانية, سراً وعلانية, سراً, إن تبدو الصدقات, if you want it. That's your choice. Allah gave you that choice. So if you want to choose to declare it, Allah يزيدك ألف خير. If you want to choose to give it privately, give it to the brothers in the pledge forms, and then they will do it for you, inshallah. طيب, أي واحد يدينا, inshallah, $1,000. Another 1,000, Allahu Akbar. جزاك الله خيرا. That's number four. I need number five. One more. واحد. One more. One more for $1,000. We got one. Allahu Akbar. MashaAllah. Tabarak Allah. You got the second one too? Did we open another bracket? Now you got six or five? No. But you have another one and some hands were coming out and then a hand over there. That we saw it. The brothers will bring it forth to you. كم عملنا? خمسة? MashaAllah. We are at 45,000. Time. We are not yet halfway through, right? أنا خطيتكم على challenge. I put you wallahi, الله الله داخل على رمضان وأنا راجل عمري 70 سنة كتبت وصيتي وحضرت قبري كل هذا صدقا لأن الرسول عليه السلام قال إيش قال أعمار أمتي وأنا ما أخاف من الحياة أنا والدي عاش 93 سنة على مدى 33 سنة كان كفن ومحنوط وصابون وكل عندنا نحن 33 سنة جبت أولادي I brought my kids they start crying قلتهم شوف يا أولادي أبوكم 70 أنا الآن دخلت 70 by the end of this year جاني وبكون اكتملت 70 I don't know when I'm going but I don't know whether I'm going to stay قلتهم شوفوا لكن تكونوا ready you don't know if I go tomorrow ما تشتتوا ما تتعبوا كده this is كده كتبت سلمتم كل شيء خلاص I am telling you والله وأنا أنظر إلى قبري بكلمكم هذا الكلام الآن كويس ما يندم الإنسان على أي إنفاق ينفق في سبيل الله سبحانه وتعالى خاصة للأولاد الصغار هذول الجوعة والعطشة يعني لما الرسول يقول السرور الأولاد سائلين من يعرف إنه والله somebody from Canada send us this somebody from Canada السرور يدخل على قلب المسلم يرفع درجتك عند الله سبحانه وتعالى ودرجة في الجنة ما بين السماء قلت هذا اليوم في الخطبة الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام actually دي آية في القرآن في سورة مريم ربنا يقول وللآخرة أكبر درجات وأكبر تفضيلة الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام شرح الآية this verse said as for the جنة or آخرة is much more ranked then they asked رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ما بين الدرجتين he said الجنة 100 درجة 100 ranks ما بين الدرجتين ما بين السماء والأرض who gets this اقرأوا معي قال سارعوا وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض وعدت لمين للمتقين هو أردي أول حاجة قال الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين These are the people qualify for paradise Mind you I can take you on a totally different route Anything that you believe in Islam, any virtue, take me for it. Any virtue we believe it in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Islam is associated to giving. The highest virtue of us is what? Taqwa, right? Iman. You know Allah said, آمنوا بالله ورسوله وأنفقوا. فالذين آمنوا منكم وأنفقوا لهم أجر كبير. طيب شوف كل آيات الإيمان مربوطة بالعطاء بالgiving التقوى second virtue I can go in all the verses in the Quran Allah said this سارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم even بداية البقرة ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى لمين
للمتقين. Who are they؟ الذين ينفق الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة وبعدها على طول ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. وسابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض وعدت للمتقين. Who are these؟ الذين ينفقون. First category. طيب أستحمي نفسك من النار. The shield from hellfire is taqwa, right? And the people will be shielded from hellfire and people will give. Read with me, billahi. نحن, sometimes I take people in the Quran in slow motion. You know slow motion? We read it verse by verse and pause on it. Read with me. كلكم تعرفوا سورة الليل. Allah says, والليل إذا يقشى, by the night when it covers. والنهار إذا تجلى, by the day when it opens or splendors. وما خلق الذكر والأنثى, and by the one who created the male and the female. Indeed, إن سعيكم لشتى. Everyone sitting here, you have your own agendas, you have your own worries. خلاص, he said, forget it. How? قال فأما من أعطى واتقى وصدق بالحسنى فسنيسره لليسرى. You have your worries, you have. Allah said, forget it. Give, and Allah takes care of the rest. Now, it didn't stop there. وأما من بخل واستغنى, person who wants, فسنيسره للعسرة, make it difficult for him. وما يغني عنه ماله إذا تردى. I'm reading this surah. Your wealth will not help you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, فأنذرتكم نارا تلظى, and I warn you from hellfire, the blazing hellfire. Now, who goes to hellfire? He said, لا يصلاها إلا الأشقى, the most miserable person who will be thrown into hellfire. Now, look at the opposite. He said, وسيجنبها الأتقى. And a person who is muttaqi, he will be shielded from hellfire. Who is he? Allah says, الذي يؤتي ما له يتزكى. وما لأحد عنده من نعمة. By the way, this is the verse that fits straight here. He said, وما لأحد عنده من نعمة تجزى إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى. He said, he will knock for nothing. You don't know a child, you know. All what you do is that you want to do it for the sake of Allah and solely for the sake of Allah. ما من نعمة تجزى إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى. And then Allah concluded by saying, ولسوف يرضى. Indeed, Allah will please you when you come to 1,000. ما شاء الله. كم 1,000؟ أنا عندي فيجر ليها يعني. كم عملت بسرعة لأنه what time is مغرب time؟ مغربكم الساعة كم؟ أنا عايز ما أطيل على الناس أكثر من كده. كم المغرب عندكم؟ We have time, and you want to feed people after Maghrib? Good for you. طيب, نحن وصلنا كم الآن؟ ما شاء الله 51. We just crossed half of the way out. طيب, let me say this now. We don't want to stop at 1,000. You sure? Oh, قلت لي 100. أنا حسبت 60. طيب, دي نحلف على طلاق السودانيين. السودانيين يقول لك والله دي نحلف. او ماي وايف سيز دونت جو اند بلاي ويز مي بيكوز يقول لك نحلف على الطلاق. الطلاق معناها وي ار كلوز تو اور تارجت, وي ار ات 53 رايت. والاخوه رحمونا, انا قلت 100 هم قالوا 60. طيب لا ونحن سوان الان بيقول حلف على الطلاق, احنا بقينا نخاف من السوان الان. ستاي توري بيكوز ويمن ناو كان سي عليه الطلاق, وانت تروح حقك يروح في كندا ممكن تطلق المرأة. That's it. ما تخافوا. طيب عندنا now almost 54. فنحن we are short by 6,000. خلينا أوريكم. There is a good formula. We're going to make the 6,000. خلاص. والله الله يجزيكم خير. I'm pretty sure if you reach your target, everybody will go here. وانتوا عملتوا العمل. I did the talking, you did the work. Right? I'd make this deal. بس خليني أكمل الكلام اللي قلته لكم. سورة الليل, this chapter titled الليل, is oaths. والليل إذا يخشى, by the night, by كده, by كده. Then Allah at the end says, none but the most miserable person will go to hellfire, right? وسيجنبها الأتقى, and a person who is a متقي, Allah سبحانه وتعالى will shield him or her from hellfire. Who is he? Allah said, الذي يؤتي ما له يتزكى, is the one who gives from his wealth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleanse him and purify him. This is why Allah commanded Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Command. He said to him, خذ من أموالهم. Take it from them. Sadaqah. Why? You want to purify them and to cleanse them. It's for our own good. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does it for us, inshallah. Now الآن we are at 53. Actually almost 54. فعايزين نكمل المسألة. نحن وقفنا عند الألف.
I'm going to look for 10 people to give me $500. Now, $500 is this. It is $50 per month. And if you make this platform and you place $50 a month, you will cover the $500 in 1 year. Type, who's going to start? 500. One, mashallah. Two, that's one. Two, huh? Quickly. Three, ashara. Ijuna ashara. Three, $500. Wallahi ma tandamu alayha. Wallahi, when you give for the sake of Allah, you protect yourself. You protect your wealth. You protect your health. بعدين أنا الآن تعلمت شيء. صرت أنفق على أمي وعلى أبوي. على just make it. من قبيل البر. من البر. حتى لو if you donate it. Donate something in the name of your mother. Donate something in the name of your father. Donate something for the sake of your children. The Prophet said, حصنوا أموالكم. Safeguard your wealth by charity. حصنوا أموالكم بالصدقة. داووا مرضاكم بالصدقة. الرسول يقول هذا. خلاص؟ في بعض روايات الحديث والناس قال حصنوا أولادكم بالصدقة. Our children are so vulnerable. You don't know if a child goes wrong, he will spin you. Give charity. Say, يا الله, this is أحفظ بها أولادي. To protect my children for it. طيب, I have 2 500s. I need more. Let me see your hand for 500s. Number three, the إخوات هناك, and I don't see the people at the back. So if there is a sister want to put $500, لأي قرض إن شاء الله. We are very, mashallah, now we are at 55,800, almost 56. Close to, we're going to read the charge إن شاء الله. طيب, who's going to add another $500? Help us to finish this. With that intention, قل أنا عايز أكمل. ربنا يفتح عليك ويكمل عليك كل ما عندك إن شاء الله. نعم. Another 500. Another 500. Nine 500. 500. ما شاء الله. Now at 56. Almost. يعني we're very close إن شاء الله. Any 500. أي حد يعطينا 500. 500. $500. 500. 500. I said $50 per month. By the way, listen to this. I lived in the States for 10 years. طبعا تعبوني مخابرات وبلاوي because of fundraising. لأن في أمريكا الناس بيدفعوا فلوس. يعني عادة يعملوا مليون ما كده. خلاص نحن الآن ما شاء الله. شوف ما شاء الله. خلونا نكمل 100 يا أخي. الناس good spirit الآن. But let me finish this and I'm going to leave you إن شاء الله. In 1 year, حملة أمريكا كلها. هناك طبعا الناس يجمعوا مليون ومليون ونص عادي المساجد وحاجات بالشكل. فجمعنا 12 مليون دولار. 12 مليون. Every time they hold me 3 hours, 50 hours, وين 12 مليون دولار؟ قلت لهم يا جماعة أنا ما عندي 12 مليون. بجي هنا بجمع تبرعات بتكلم وبمشي. الراجل يقول لي So you are not a fundraiser. قلت What am I? قال لي You are a motivation speaker. قلت له جزاك الله خير. He crossed the world ورحموني بكذا. The next time the man held me. قاعد يقول لي As a fundraiser. قلت له والله أنا ما fundraiser. قال لي What are you? قلت له I'm a motivation speaker. بقى يقول لي As a motivation speaker What do you do? قلت له والله بيتكلم عن الناس. لما قال واحد يعني تكلم فيهم بعدين الناس يجمعوا الفلوس وأنا أمشي. والله هكذا. فقال لي نو خلاص أنت you qualify as a motivation speaker and they release me. 5 سنوات منعوني من دخول أمريكا. والله قلت له يا جماعة أخاف من المال. ليش؟ قلت لهم يا احنا نلقطها واحدة 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 عن المسلمين. أنتوا عندكم أطمان من المال ما حد يسأل حد إن شاء الله. فوالله اسمعوا الكلام. حقرأ عليكم آية واحدة أو آيتين وأذكركم بشيء تسمعوه. ربنا في القرآن يقول شنو؟ اسمعوا الآية. قال يا أيها الذين دي آخر سورة التوبة. I really want you to listen to it. And I'm going to read it as is. عشان أقول لك إيش ربنا بيقول. قال يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. Oh, ye who believe, fear Allah and be among the honest people, the sincere people. طيب؟ مع الصادقين. قال وما كان لأهل المدينة. Allah talks to the people of Medina. ومن حولهم من الأعراب أن يتخلفوا عن رسول الله. خلاص؟ ولا يرغبوا بأنفسهم عن نفسه. ذلك بأنهم لا يصيبهم ظمأ. ولا يصيبهم ظمأ ولا مخمصة ولا نصب في سبيل الله. ولا يطئون موطئا يغيظ الكفار. ولا ينالون من عدو نيلا إلا كتب لهم طيب به عمل صالح إن الله لا يضيع أجر المحسنين.
بعدين قال بعدها إيش؟ ولا ينفقون نفقة صغيرة ولا كبيرة، صغيرة ولا كبيرة، ولا ينالون من عدو نيلا إلا كتب لهم عمل لايك ليجزيهم الله أحسن كذا. خلاص بعدها طوالي الله سبحانه وتعالى يذكرنا بإحنا مين. So الحمد لله now actually passed the target بتاعكم بتاع 60. لكن I'm going to let you go with this. Allah actually let me say what the Prophet said. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام went said to the صحابة قال لا يأتينكم أحد يوم القيامة. Then none of you should come on the day of judgment among one of two people. You know who are these people? He said one of them will say يقول يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي. I wish I had an opportunity to give tonight. You have the opportunity. You don't know whether you're going to have this opportunity or not. He says, يقول, Allah said this in the Quran. يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي. I wish I had advanced something for myself. So don't come like that. You can advance anything. نفقة صغيرة ولا كبيرة. It doesn't matter to Allah. He said the second people person will come and say, يقول يا ليتني كنت معهم. فأفوز فوزا عظيما. I wish I had been with them. Now you are all with us, right? Don't leave without doing something. صغيرة ولا كبيرة. الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام going to conclude this. He says, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. Never look at anything as small, insignificant. ما بتقدر ما حاجة كده وما تستحي إنك تعطي أي شيء لله. Because this might be the only thing you can claim on the day of judgment to save you from hellfire. إحنا مقبلين على رمضان. في رمضان بيقول لك البلحة تمرة. Right? What did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say? He said, اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. تمرة, a fraction of a date can be the thing that you need to relieve yourself from hellfire. So, don't feel shy at all. أنا بمشي كل يوم في fundraising. خلاص؟ بخط يدي أي شيء عندي يطلع عندي أطلع أخطه وامشي لأن يوم القيامة ما يتكمن كلمة الله سبحانه وتعالى. So I want you, الحمد لله نحن الآن على 71. This can raise to 80. I don't know how much I have, but تعذروني. But anything that I have, I'll give it. I don't shy from it. خلاص؟ لأن يوم القيامة I might claim this to الله سبحانه وتعالى. والله أنا كل ليلة بمشي مرات في الويكند 3 فندريزي. عملت عادة. أدفع قرش 3, 10, 20, 30 أي شيء لأنه I want to be with the people who do it. So please تمشي من الطاولة دي. Every table, sister, brothers, حتى even your children. الولد الآن قلت لك بيدفع 100,000 اليوم كان أبوي يدي 5 دولارات 10 دولارات ويجي يقف. والله تعلم الإنفاق من ذي. أنا قرأت كتاب بالمناسبة يمكن بعضكم سمع به. There is a book, a beautiful book بالعربي للأسف الشديد ما أعرف مترجم أو لا. I don't know if it's translated. The book by اللي هو عبد يماني. عبد يماني كان نط وزير البترول السعودي. كان هو وزير الإعلام السعودي. عمل مؤسسة إقرأ. He has this إقرأ international educational thing. ومات الرجل في المحكمة. He died in a court defending Islamic schools. نسأل الله له المغفرة. ربنا يجزاه. كتب كتاب he wrote a beautiful book لو لقيتوه الناس العرب بالذات اسمه علموا أولادكم حب رسول الله. علموا أولادكم حب رسول الله. Teach your children how they love رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. خلاص أنا الآن حقول لكم دعوة تانية أسأل الله لو أمد في عمري. I don't write but if I write any book I will start with a book titled علموا أولادكم الإنفاق. حقيقة teach your children to be donors. Teach them to be people who can give this donation. أمسك ولدك الصغير بنتك أدي 5 دولارات, $2, $3 let them start feeling that they have the dignity and the pride that they contribute like any other person إن شاء الله. طيب من الله سبحانه وتعالى يعني ما شاء الله we are at 72 it will come to 75 maybe even 100 I'm not going to bother you more than that. جزاكم الله خيرا. We say سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك وصلى اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم. Please don't leave. Don't leave without contributing even a dollar. ما تجي يوم القيامة تقول I wish I had done it. Just do it.
ما تجي تقول I wish I had been with them. يا ليتني كنت معهم. You are now with us. Be party to it. خلي أولادك زوجتك أي شيء عندك إن شاء الله تبيت. جزاكم الله خيرا. May Allah reward you إن شاء الله. ربنا يجزيكم خيرا على دعوتكم لي. أعطتونا خير كثير إن شاء الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. وصلى اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.